Addressing the media today during the weekly security briefing, the Uganda National Examinations Board revealed that the UCE exams that kicked off 3 weeks ago are progressing very well. So far, a total of 26 papers have been written.
The English examination marks the end of the will mark the end of a series of compulsory papers or subjects for the candidates, and thereafter, candidates are going to begin writing elective papers. These elective subjects are very important because just in case a candidate misses writing out on any of the elective subjects which are registered for, such a candidate is not going to be graded. We therefore want to caution the candidates to ensure that they actually do all the elective papers that they registered for.
Karule disclosed that a few cases of exam malpractice have been reported by volunteers, leading to the arrest of the culprits. The latest case is that of Segwa Karim, a TikToker who was arrested over the weekend.
We had another notorious suspect who was trending as a Fresh Karim on social media, and this one did start up a TikTok platform where he would daily share material said to be unique examinations. He was arrested on Thursday, October 26th, after sharing a fake history paper the previous day. He's currently under police custody and is due to appear before court to answer charges of unauthorized possession of material said to be UNEP examinations.
The board has now tightened its exam security and are now monitoring all online platforms for any suspected dealers in exam papers.
Aware that many schools devise various ways of indulging in malpractice. We therefore want to caution you and to confirm that we are tightening our security measures and working along with other security agencies to ensure that the work done so far is not failed. We have positioned both permanent and undercover scouts as well as security operatives to oversee the work of the invigilators during the conduct of the examinations during the remaining weeks of the UCE exams.
According to the UNEB Act of 2021, involvement in any form of exam malpractice is an offence and can lead to cancellation of the results of a candidate, and while those involved in facilitating the act, either willfully or unwillfully, are charged under Section 25 of the UNEB Act. For such an offence of aiding and abetting malpractice, once convicted, a person is liable to a fine of between 20 to 40 million shillings or to do a term of imprisonment ranging between 5 to 10 years. From the Uganda Police Force, a police detective in Buyende District has been dismissed from the force for raping a woman who had gone to the police to report a case of domestic violence. Inanga said that Detective Valikowa will later be arraigned in courts of law to face charges of rape.
6:30 p.m., our officer, Detective Inspector Valikowa, asked the victim to go with him. He had found a place for her to sleep. He instead drove her to his home in Nakabira Police Barracks. They bought food and drinks and afterwards sexually assaulted this vulnerable housewife on two occasions. And in the morning around 9 a.m., he dropped the victim near Namsita Police Post and promised to arrest her husband.
Meanwhile, in a bid to fight terrorism, police in Rwenzori region have arrested an ADF collaborator in Chitagwenda district. Upon arrest, Farouk Masiko confessed that he had been recruited into the rebel group in 2015 and has since been working as their spy.
He admitted that he was at one time in the ADF ranks after being kidnapped around 2015. In River Nyamwamba, Kasese, and taken to the DRC, where he was trained as an intelligence officer. The suspect is well-versed with areas of Bundibujo, Wera, Luwero, Najanankumbi, and he claims he escaped from California ADF camp in the DRC.
From the Directorate of Traffic and Road Safety, a total of 423 road accidents were registered between October 23rd and 29th. And in these, over 60 people lost their lives, while 338 sustained serious injuries. According to police, the common cause of the crashes were careless overtaking and overspeeding. Police have also tipped drivers on overtaking to avoid causing accidents while on the road.
Kidnapping is risky, and you first have to ask yourself whether you must overtake. And if you must overtake, you have to ensure the following things. One, you have to ensure that the road is sufficiently clear ahead of you.
Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.